Today is Thursday.
November 17th.
And the news starts now.
Let's keep it moving to the weekend in Anoka. I'm Miski.
And I'm Varney. And the countdown to the end of Try One is going strong. 7 days, 2 short weeks, more important for all you seniors who haven't bought your cap and gowns yet. You have 6 days to get it done. The deadline is next Wednesday. Check your info, check your emails for more info.
Yup.
You're supposed to come. Keeping with the topic of time, let's start this day with a riddle about it. Maria and Jordan were born simultaneously, but have two different birthdays. How can this be? Think beyond the local and you'll get it. As you're spinning that around, let's talk about the STEAM showcase and professional review that took place last night.
Just about 200 Anoka High School STEAM students filled the main commons and cafeteria last night to showcase and generate review ideas for work. From the freshmen in caffeinated imagination, kinetic design, edible marketing, and dystopian engineering, to the sophomores, design lab students, the AP Studio Art, Culinary One, interior design, and the 58 seniors who had their projects up for review, it was hectic, informative, and a fun night. Some footage and projects from the night.
It's sort of a dystopian survival class project where we made water filters.
One of the things you do is a passion project where you get to pick any topic you want to like really dive into. I chose video production and I made a video showing and talking about why you should get animals and the benefits that you can get from animals.
Usually they.
So a lot of these pieces are done through digital art that I did on my tablet right here that we maximized to like this huge poster paper.
So my problem with the school is that the tests are administered in like an unorganized, like unstructured way, which is like can be overwhelming for the students. My first four solutions were a calendar structure where like math tests would be on Mondays, English tests on Tuesdays, science test on Wednesdays, and history test on...
So my project is the hook helper. It's a rod tying multi-tool. It's got a bunch of different sections on it. This section is for holding hooks. This back section is going to be for cutting your hooks and cleaning out your eyes and holding your line.
So my project is Localog, and it's basically a library management software like this, except better. So basically it would allow you to track your materials in real time, and it would allow you to check out materials from your phone, Chromebook, and variety of electronic devices.
I'm making a device that can automatically defrost your car windshields in the morning when you need to leave.
So my project is a den type thing. There is the mother wolf and her pup lying in the den. The kinetic part is their tails move, and when their tails move, a little bell inside them rings. It's built with all natural materials, so sand and rocks and stuff from nature.
Don't take the time to find the problem with individual students and connect with them. And my solution was to have an individual counselor for each student.
I made posters using my photography to encourage people to register and go and watch Anoka hockey games to support them.
I made some nice advertisements for the Explore MN ad campaign. So we just want people to get outside into Minnesota and enjoy the great scenery. And so I specified mine into biking.
My project is an F-22, and there's a green light on the right and a red light on the left. It's supposed to resemble an F-22.
You know, when you're swimming or you have working goggles or, you know, just regular glasses, it sucks when you cannot see. When your goggles start fogging, your face, because your two arteries here or the rest of your blood vessels heat up. And as they heat up, your face generates a lot of heat. These will not really do that.
Great work, you all, and great work to the volleyball players who came down to the field house to set up nets, spike some volleyballs, and spend an evening with friends and foes for the DECA volleyball tournament. It was a packed event, but at the end of the night, there were four teams left competing. Tyler Pachta and Hot Pinks faced off for third against Carmen Rosser's Orange team in the championship round. Nathan Lindberg and Pink team did battle with Elijah Vang and Greens. Despite opening with a 2-0 lead in the Green team, couldn't handle the heat, and Pink left the night with a medal in their mouths. Thanks for all who came out last night.
You might want to get out and go down and get down to the counselor's office to change your trimester 2 and 3 schedule. The window for schedule changes opened yesterday and today. And tomorrow is the last day to bring in food for the food drive. You see these bags, they're sitting in your first hour class waiting for you to bring in some food to help those who cannot make ends meet. Please help out if you are one of the students in need of that. Remember that Miss Mosman runs Tornado Takeout here at Anoka. See the posters or video screens to learn more.
That's all for announcements, so let's quickly run clubs. Avid Club, Asian Club, and Tornado Tales Book Club are taking place tonight. And then tomorrow morning, Pickleball, that's his pickle, sets up nets at 6 now. Let's pass it over to sports.
Most teams are in the off-season here, so the action will take place in practice. Girls basketball, boys hockey, and freshman boys basketball are holding tryouts. The wrestling team is hosting open mat time, and everyone else is prepping for the competition. This weekend, a few groups who are competing are the Anoka Dance Team, who starts their season on Saturday with the Bernard Dance Invitational, and the Anoka Cheer Team goes to East Ridge for their second competition of the season. Girls hockey also hosts another home game against Osseo/Park Center. The puck drops at 1 for JV and 3 for varsity. Finally, the girls swim and dive team is down at the University of Minnesota competing in the state tournament, which will be streamed on NSPN TV. Junior Kristen Bailey takes the diving board today, and the lanes open for swim competition tomorrow. That's all from sports. I'm sorry if I said your name wrong. Back to the news desk.
Be fierce, girls. We're going to end today's show running from some photos from last night's event. Before we leave and head to Friday, let's get you the lunch menu. Teriyaki chicken fried rice, turkey cheese croissant, and a crispy chicken salad. I'm Miski.
And I'm Varney, and the answer to today's riddle about how two people at the same moment, at the same exact moment, can have different birthdays is they live in completely different time zones. Think beyond yourself, Anoka.
Far, Anoka.
It's a hurricane party, end days every other Wednesday. Live girls dance, dead men flow. A hurricane party, gold dust checks and Cardi. DJ says don't hold back because the water won't. Looks like someone leaked the pad.